Bitcoin saw a huge bounce yesterday. Right now we have seen a daily close above the 50-day moving average. Guys, I'm going to show you exactly what I think is going to happen right here in the Bitcoin price. And we are also going to have a talk about, what is happening right now in Bitcoin with the Bitcoin price, but as well in the relationship of altcoins. So guys, all about that in today's video. With that being said, my name is Jeroen. Welcome to the Blockchain Today, the channel where you subscribe for daily crypto videos. Right now, let's jump into the Bitcoin price action, guys. But before we are zooming in right here on the Bitcoin price, let's take with every single one of us one single minute, scroll below this video and hit the thumbs up button. Guys, super, super much appreciated. And now let's jump into the Bitcoin price. And what we have seen, guys, in the Bitcoin price is that right now I've get rid of my drawings, right? I just wanted to have a look at the moving average right here. This is the 50-day moving average. We will also have a look at the 20-day, just to get a feel of what the structure that is forming right now in Bitcoin, right? So we broke below the 50-day, which normally is a bearish sign. We got a further drop, right? Afterwards, we got a bounce, and right now the price action is actually quite choppy. We broke back above the 50-day, we broke back below the 50-day, right now we broke back above. And normally, guys, when we are seeing such price action right here, there is no clear direction in the Bitcoin price. And it's also very, very difficult to predict in the shorter term time frame what is going to happen with the Bitcoin price. Right now we are in a choppy sideways range, and that is one of the hardest periods to trade Bitcoin against US dollar. So I would definitely not advise you guys right here to try and open leverage trades on Bitcoin. If you want to trade Bitcoin in these regions, you really want to like look into scalp trading, but it's very difficult to trade a certain direction. Like we can see it in the past as well. Right here we also had like the Bitcoin price just moving sideways, choppy. We don't really know what is going on with the Bitcoin price, right? We first need to see momentum coming back. We need to see a clear direction in order to say with more confidence in which direction Bitcoin is going. And right now we're just moving sideways, which is a very logical thing because we have seen a huge momentum rally right here, right, where we just basically went from if we calculate it from here, basically from 10,000 to $65,000, and it's more than logical for Bitcoin to take a breather right here, which brings a lot of opportunities in the altcoin world, right? So we see a lot of liquidity going into altcoins, a lot of altcoins outperforming Bitcoin in the Bitcoin comparative, right? We have been trading a lot of them right here on the channel as well. So that is the moment right now, guys, where you have to be present in. You have to be present in these altcoin pairs, because that is right now where the money is. It's not there yet in Bitcoin in the US dollar comparative. It might come very soon. We might see the momentum coming back in Bitcoin, and I'm going to show you exactly which signals we need to be watching in order for that to happen. But right now, this specific moment, guys, it is very difficult to predict the exact price of Bitcoin in the short-term time frame due to the fact that there is no clear direction. And one of the signs is the 50-day moving average, moving sideways, price breaking above, breaking below it. That's something we don't really see in the past, right? When we break below, we have a bearish trend. When we break above, we have a bullish trend. Unless the price is moving sideways. I don't know, guys, if you can still remember this price range, but a lot of traders, they got confused in this period because the price of Bitcoin was just moving sideways. We didn't get a clear direction up or down. So yeah, it was just very difficult to trade Bitcoin in this period. And right now we are seeing a little bit more volatility, of course, but we are seeing something similar. No clear direction, just moving sideways. And the majority of the attention in the crypto markets right now is on altcoins. But we still can see some things in the Bitcoin comparative. And I want to point out some things which need to happen for Bitcoin in order to really get that momentum back. So guys, first of all, what I want to do is I want to bring out the momentum indicators right here on the daily time frame. And I want to bring out the RSI, but I also want to bring out the MACD. And yeah, I have been talking about these momentum indicators recently, but I think this is definitely something that needs to happen. This is a very significant signal, guys. It's very nice that we are seeing such a signal, because right now we have on both the RSI and the MACD, we have a declining resistance, which means, which coincides that Bitcoin is consolidating, moving sideways, right? Normally in a bull market, this can be a bullish sign where the price is moving sideways and the momentum indicators, they are resetting, creating space for more bullish momentum. But if Bitcoin wants to get more bullish momentum and really wants to break out right here, we really need to break above the resistance, above the declining resistance on the RSI, but as well above the resistance on the MACD. That is very important, because that is really showing us that the structure in the momentum is changing and that we have enough power, enough fuel for a switch to a more, to a scenario, a more bullish scenario, a more bullish outcome in the chart. So that is one of the things. If Bitcoin wants to get its momentum back, wants to start a new rally, this needs to happen. Then guys, let's have a look at the Bitcoin price action, like what kind of pattern we are trading in. Well, if we go to the 4-hour time frame, let me zoom out a little bit. We had this rising wedge pattern, we broke out to the downside, right? And yeah, right now the price action is just quite choppy, but we are trading in quite a clear descending channel right here. And as you can see, the support of the channel is getting respected quite good. We had a fake out below it right here. But the interesting thing right here, guys, and this is normally when I'm using channels and determine the significance of certain channels, is how much is the middle of the channel getting respected as well. Because right here, the top is getting respected. But as you can see, the middle of the channel is being respected quite significantly. Right here we get supported by this level. Right here, this level is acting as resistance. Right here is acting as resistance as well. Right here we break above, we get a nice reaction in the price. Right here we got rejected from the top. Right now we got a bounce from the middle of the channel. So this is actually, yeah, quite a significant channel, right? Showing that, showing a lot of significance with the Bitcoin price, with the reaction of the Bitcoin price. So this is the structure that I'm watching in the chart. If Bitcoin wants to become bullish again, guys, we really want to break above the declining resistance and change the market structure right here. Change the structure from a descending channel into a new market structure, which might be a new uptrend. But this needs to coincide if we really want to have that power in the momentum and power in the price. We really need to break above the declining resistances in the momentum indicators on the daily time frame in order to get the momentum back for Bitcoin to set a sufficient rally where we can break above the previous all-time highs right here at approximately $65,000. So guys, that is what I'm looking at right now in the Bitcoin chart. I'm looking at this descending channel, and I would expect Bitcoin to continue to trade in this channel unless we are seeing a nice breakout right here. The next the resistance of the channel right now is at approximately $58,000. If we were to break above that level, the next resistance, the next major resistance, is at approximately $60,000. Then guys, let's go to Chainlink in the Bitcoin comparative, because we have seen a nice rally and yeah, we got rejected slightly below our exact target, right? I've been talking about, guys, that you should be targeting the lower 90,000 Satoshi levels, and we actually got a very, very precise rejection from that level. And guys, this is a very important thing normally when we are analyzing altcoins. We have such a macro structure right here with a extreme top and a extreme bottom. Normally when we are seeing a reversal, which we are seeing right now, Adam and Eve pattern, breaking above resistances, setting higher lows, right? Then we are almost always, it's almost a guarantee that we are getting rejected from the 61.80%. This is such a significant level if this level is based on a macro chart, which it is right here. It is the top right here in 2020 with the bottom right here in 2020. But this is based on approximately a little bit longer than 1 year price action. So this is a macro scale. So that is actually quite significant. Right now we are getting rejected. So guys, for everybody who's interested in still opening a trade over on Chainlink, you could do it as follow. We calculate the Fibonacci levels right here from the bottom to the top. Then we can see that the 38.20% is aligning slightly with the previous resistance, right? So if I were to increase my Chainlink holdings, guys, I would do it right here at these levels approximately. I would think that would make sense if Chainlink wants to continue this uptrend in the Bitcoin comparative to pick it up approximately right there. But of course, it was way better to already enter this trade from these green levels right here. Then you are already, how much up you got from your trade right now, you would be up like approximately 73%. And from the top, you would have made a trade of almost 100%, like 93%, which is quite significant. But guys, like I said in my video yesterday, I've been pointing out this target exactly. And you always have to set your target below the actual target, because here you can see as well, we didn't touch that level exactly, because a lot of traders are watching that level and they all put their sell orders slightly below it, because they know that they are not the only one watching it. So that's always very important thing to do. Never set your target at the actual target. Always set the target below, so you have a better certainty that you are getting out of your trade with profit. Then guys, I want to bring out EOS in the Bitcoin comparative, because we have been trading EOS in the Bitcoin comparative. I have been mentioning it right here on the channel, but I also made a call on my members section on the Blockchain Today website, where I provided everybody with exact entry points right here and an exact entry point the moment we broke out. And right now we have seen that breakout, guys, and this is just looking very, very bullish. EOS in the Bitcoin comparative is just looking very good. We broke above a multi-year long declining resistance, and we broke above that resistance with a nice spike in the volume. So that is actually just looking very bullish. If we go to the weekly time frame, guys, we can even see it more clearly. And what I've shared over on the members section on the Blockchain Today was that we have a very bullish pattern right here. We get a multi-year long declining resistance, right? But we also saw that on the weekly RSI, but we already broke that resistance on the weekly RSI. We backtested that resistance as support that we did right here before we even broke out in the price. So we've already positioned us right here, and that trade right now is up approximately 46% in the Bitcoin comparative. So this is quite massive, guys, without leverage, just trading on the spot market, trading these altcoins with the wide entries and a little bit of patience. Right now we are up on this trade 46%, which is just a amazing trade, right? So guys, this is another altcoin I wanted to point out, which is thriving right now in the Bitcoin comparative. Just have seen a major breakout, and I expect EOS in the Bitcoin comparative right here to continue this uptrend and to reach the targets that we have been setting along the way. And guys, just another example to show you the significance of the golden ratio. Right here we have Ethereum in the Bitcoin comparative. Nice uptrend. Crazy rally recently, right? But also I've drawn here from the top till the bottom a macro Fibonacci chart. And we can see that slightly below the 61.80%. We are getting, we are seeing this wick. So a lot of people sold right there. A lot of traders sold. So that is quite interesting, guys. And what is also interesting right here is that, again, we are seeing the sell wick, like, actually slightly below this level, which means, guys, that this is just a level a lot of people are watching, and a lot of traders have their sell orders slightly below to anticipate on that event and to make sure that they are exiting their trade with profit. But okay, guys, that is what I'm looking at right now in the Bitcoin and in the altcoin space. I think right now is really the time to trade altcoins in the Bitcoin comparative. You should wait with trading Bitcoin unless you are a very good scalper. Then it can definitely be nice. But right now, you should definitely wait with Bitcoin till we are getting a more clearer direction and when it's a little bit more easier to predict the price of Bitcoin. And for that to happen, we really want to see that breakout in the momentum indicators, and we want to see a change of the market structure in price that we are seeing right now. But okay, guys, that was it for today's video. I hope you all enjoyed today's analysis. Guys, if you enjoyed today's video, make sure to scroll below this video, hit the thumbs up button, very much appreciated. Then I want to wish every single one of you an awesome day today, and I will see every single one of you in the next video.